But I have another thing to consider, and that is the amount of people that are already coming up to me and want to touch my belly.
Uh-oh. You've talked to me about this off the air, that everybody wants to come up and rub the Melissa belly, and and you're just really not digging it. Even when, are they even doing it when you ask them not to? They just go ahead and say, oh, I want to rub it anyway?
You know, it's just, yeah, I don't say don't touch the belly. I mean, I've gone as far as, like, actually wearing a shirt with a big circle around it with a line through it, you know, like, do not touch or something.
So you've asked somebody not to, and they go ahead and reach in anyway?
I kind of give them the look like, oh, you're going to be one of those people that want to touch the belly. And I literally got, shut up, just let me touch it.
And how does that make you feel? I mean, they're excited for you. We all are. Can't wait to for the birth of your baby boy. Yeah. It's real exciting. But you know, there are pet peeves through pregnancies, and this happens to be your number one pet peeve.
And I'm sure I'm not the only one that this has happened to. You know, it's and
well, I can imagine somebody say, "Hey, Ross, let me rub your belly. It's a little uncomfortable."
And just complete strangers will come up to you, want to touch your belly, and these are people that wouldn't normally come up to you and want to touch you in some kind of way, aside
most
from shaking
your hand.
Most people
wouldn't want to come up and rub your belly.
Yeah, it's just kind of an awkward thing. Like if I were just, you know, an overweight person, I don't think anyone would come on over saying, did you just eat yourself a big old sandwich? Let me touch that belly. You know, it's just, it's weird.
At the buffet.
You know, I've got like ketchup on my face and all that. They wouldn't do that.
Rub it on down in there.
So that is just a pet peeve that I have.
So do you need some help with on how to say something to folks so that when they start this, that doesn't offend them?
I guess.
And let them know that you're really not digging them rubbing your belly.
I don't even know if there is a way to say it without being rude.
293 or 683. Let's help Melissa out. 9797 or 800-227-9797. Tom, I bet you're one of those rubbing Melissa's belly every day.
Well, I
you love to touch, don't you, brother?
Yeah, I am just, you know, like, actually, I've done that in the past, you know. What I like to do is actually lean over and talk to the kid while he's in there and go, when you grow up, be a bad boy, you know.
Oh, Melissa.
That's right. He is always talking to him. That's why I feel my baby always asleep.
Yeah.
Tom has got the touch.
Yes. Yes. Instead of rubbing your belly, I talk to the kid. Tell him how to live his life, you know what I'm saying?
Come on over after he's born anytime.
Okay.
Are you sure you want to invite that
in? Yeah. Okay, let me think twice about that.
Wow.
Oh, boy.
Y'all's body, you know, we tell kids don't let people touch them in ways that make them uncomfortable. You know, people should not touch people in ways that make them uncomfortable.
Totally with you.
Now let's check this theory out here. If Brad Pitt walked into this studio for an interview, would he be allowed to touch your belly, no questions asked?
I will give him a bottle of cocoa butter, and he could rub it all over.
See, she's really not that worried about it, is she?
He's not a stranger. I see him in movies.
Hey, good morning. I know whenever I was pregnant, I was like a walking, what's sort of like a touch and feel museum. Everybody would walk by and touch me. And I honestly, you can't say, hey, don't touch me without being rude. Especially when you're pregnant, you're hormonal. One of the things that just don't work out well.
Hey, what's this walking, talking museum's name?
My name's Cherry.
Thank you.
Oh, thanks. Thanks for nothing. 97 Country.
Hi. First of all, let me just say congratulations on you guys' win.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And most people that want to touch a pregnant woman's belly touch it for luck. They say that it's really? Very
so
lucky.
I'm Buddha now. That's what that's about.
Well, I wouldn't say that it's Buddha, but that's what most people used to do that to me all the time when I was pregnant. And they say that to touch a pregnant woman's belly, it brings you luck.
So what you're saying is we need to tie Melissa's hands behind her back.
Not really. I mean, if she's
send her over to Lakeside Village on Saturday evening and let her stand there and get all kinds of luck wishes.
Sounds fantastic.
Well, a lot of times it'll be mostly women like to do it, especially women that are trying to conceive. They'll rub another pregnant woman's belly.
Okay, I can do that.
Yeah, so I mean, it's not a bad thing. It's not that they just want to touch and feel you. I think just people love babies so much that they think that it's a lucky thing. So
you're a toucher, aren't you?
I was touched a lot when I was pregnant. I think everybody at work wanted to rub my belly every time I was pregnant for luck. So
swing on by. We're off after 10. We'll put her out front, out here on Lime Street.
All right. I'll be out there.
Thanks.
See you later. Bye.
Bye.
Got to remember the duct tape tomorrow morning. We'll just duct tape your hands behind your back. You need all the luck you can get.
I'll be out there just like the swan. That's probably what will strap me
on
to, actually.
We can put you on the swan. Yeah. People can just walk by and rub your belly.
All right. We're ending this conversation
It's like a drive-thru, Melissa. Mm-hmm. Oh, but this gets better and better.